Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Suhani Mohan. I'm the founder and CEO of Saral Designs. But let me start by telling you a story of a girl called Padma. She's 12 years old and in a rural school. She's really bright and wants to become a doctor when she grows up. But today when she went to school, she stained her uniform red. She was really scared because she didn't know what really happened to her. She went back home only to hear from her mother that you should not go to school tomorrow onwards, because they did not have the means to manage her periods going forward. This is not the story of one Padma. About 23% of the girls in India drop out of school once they start menstruating. And 70% of women in India have reproductive tract infections. This is 400 million, more than the population of 50 European countries put together. A lot of women in India, firstly, do not know about sanitary napkins, how to use them. Secondly, do not have the right access in remote towns. And thirdly, they cannot really afford the commercial good quality products. And that is where we come in. We are Saral Designs and we are working towards designing a better future in menstrual hygiene. So where is the current gap? Because we see a TV commercial of sanitary napkins every 2 minutes in the market. So what's really happening? The thing is, there are good number of multinational players, mainly P&G and J&J, which are into manufacturing good quality sanitary napkins. But how a typical FMCG network works is that there are about 5 to 6 intermediaries between the producer and the final consumer. And especially for voluminous products like sanitary napkins and diapers, the margins in between are really high. So the cost of a product is increased 60% only because of this distribution cycle. They make a lot of pads together, 800 pads per minute, and super huge capacity machines. Then there was an emergence of a lot of local manufacturers in the last 5 to 7 years, because this was a gap that was identified with a lot of people. But the key challenge that was there was the quality of the product was really bad, because this is something that you would want to see. So this is something that was made out of local manufacturers, and the second challenge apart from quality, which did not create a lot of demand in the low income segment, was also the production costs were really high because they were just making one pad per minute, and as a business it never made sustainable sense that they never generated enough profits to fund in cash flows, advertise the product and take it to the market. And that's why we thought there is a significant need of disruption in this space by having a very good quality product made affordable. Secondly, creating a business model wherein we can have decentralized manufacturing but at a scale that also makes financial sense. So we came up with 20 pads per minute as the production rate of our machine. Why this is so special is that with this production rate, our cost of production is almost in line with that of multinational players. We make a pad in 1.4 rupees. Since this is still a small number, we don't need more than 2 intermediaries between the producer and the final consumer. So cutting down almost 30% on the costs there. So we are India's first and only manufacturers and designers of ultra-thin sanitary napkin making machines. So these are as good quality as Whispers and Stay Free in the market. Priya has already used it and she can endorse more about it.
Yes, it's very good. I've endorsed it.
So the core innovation that we did was develop an automatic machine to do it so that the quality doesn't suffer because of labor intervention. At the same time, it doesn't depend too much on skilling of people on the production side. Where we believe is the real disruption is required on the sales side, and that is where we involve local people. So how do we take this forward? We can either install our machines in different parts of the country and centrally control everything, but this is a very asset heavy model. So what we came to was designing Saral Stars. They are individual entrepreneurs who have experience of running small scale businesses in tier 2 cities, who purchase this machine, run it. We supply them with the raw materials and ongoing tech support and branding support. The advantage with this is they need to invest a total capital of 25 lakhs. This includes everything. The machine cost is about 13.5 lakhs, and this includes the working capital that they require for the first few months when they develop the market. And if they are able to sell whatever they produce, they can break even in a year's time. The advantage is that we have about 1.4 million micro enterprises already in the country. There are who are looking for new business opportunities. This model also helps us in quick scaling. And every entrepreneur is focusing on a limited area, so they can do a lot more activities in terms of generation of awareness and partnering with multiple informal routes of distribution, which otherwise to be able to do centrally is very difficult. So what have we done so far is that we wanted to test this model, because what we saw, there were a lot of other local manufacturers. The problem that they faced was they got into production, but the market could never develop for the product. And that is where we also took help from Marico Innovation Foundation to take the product at a commercial level. So if you see the packaging, etc., it is comparable to any branded product. We launched it through retail, so we are there in 100 retail shops across Dharavi and 50 villages around Karjat now. The other thing that we did was we identified Asha women who are there in every village in this country, and they are already trained to deliver healthcare services. So we just provide them with a product and they keep it in their home. So it's a women to women distribution channel, which solves the problem of the shyness that is there around the product. We also partner extensively with NGOs and CSR partnerships for installation of vending machines in schools, because we believe that it's a good model to start them into the habit of using sanitary napkins. And this also has helped a lot of girls not miss schools during the periods because of period emergencies. So we are also listed on Amazon. If you want to try, you can order anytime and we'll be happy to supply that to you. So far, we have sold more than 1 lakh pads already since we launched in January. Majority of it has happened in the last 3 months when we extended our arm to the rural side of the population as well. We have sold 2 manufacturing machines. We have about 15,000 users who vary across the income segments. Like you see, there are girls in colleges who are more income who are price conscious at the same time in urban slums and rural areas. So going forward, we believe that there needs to be a very robust backend to be able to support something like this, which is a franchisee led or a entrepreneur led model. So what we have done in the last the time since we started in June 2015, after developing the product and testing it in the market in terms of what pricing needs to be, how you need to position the product. Now we want to increase the production capacity and scale 5 times of what our production is, so that we can have much better interventions. The second thing, from next year onwards, early next year, we want to start into getting into our entrepreneur led model and establish this in multiple places. We are very technologically focused. We have IoT systems in the machine, which counts the number of pads that are produced, and this will help us keep track of what their raw material requirements are, and as well as provide preventive maintenance services. For this, we are looking to raise about 3 crore in this round, and we have already closed around last year with the Pavai Lake Ventures, and with this round we intend to set up the entire backend and increase our production and scale. And in the next 5 years, our intention is to increase the number of units that we have to 5,000 units. Looks like a huge number, but it is not. There are multiple entrepreneurs in India, developing countries and Africa who have shown keen interest into getting into it. With this, we'll be able to reach about 100 million users. Again, every woman needs a sanitary napkin. It's about the right product quality and the channel through which we reach them. So who are we? I am Suhani. I have graduated from IIT Bombay in 2011, worked with Deutsche Bank. I'm also an Acumen fellow before I started this venture. It was through a CSR activity only when I really got to know about the problem, and it really affected me. And I met my co-founder Karthik Mehta, who is from IIT Madras. He's the machine designer. He has designed special purpose machines for industries for the last 3 years. He worked with General Motors and had done several freelancing projects before this. Our team is a mix of people from McKinsey, to people who have been Gandhi fellows working in rural areas, to people who have actually hardcore machine design experience. We have some lovely set of mentors. Samardeep was from MIF, who guided us in terms of building the entire go-to-market strategy. We also have investors who have been in the franchisee business as well as advertising. So going forward, we have a very strong bench of mentors to catch on to. The market doesn't stop here. The menstrual hygiene market in itself is really huge. Apart from sanitary napkins, in this particular price segment, we can also go to a lower income segment, also a higher variance of it. The second thing is going into the diaper market, which is very similar in terms of manufacturing as well as the distribution side of it. And it can be replicated in any product which has a local demand and can be disrupted by a local production and distribution. So with this, I would like to close by saying that in Industrial Revolution 1, when it happened, everything was being produced centrally. So there were these huge machineries that came up and a load of supply chain was created and transportation cost and everything boomed. But now, with the help of technology, it is so much more easier to make the same quality products at a much smaller rate in an automation. And with this, we can empower not just big corporates, but also several local entrepreneurs at the same time reach to areas which have been left out from the first industrial revolution. So thank you. What I'm really looking for here is CSR partnerships as well as funding opportunities. So I'd like to take more questions. Thank you.
Support what Malik was already started. Yeah, it's very interesting. So yeah, I would love to engage further. And please, then Swaigulu, would you be interested also? Yes, wonderful. This is easy. But just a couple of quick questions. So when you are doing this franchise model, does it end with the sale of that machine, or is there a continuing engagement with it? Yeah, so we supply them with the raw materials. So the machine has been tuned in a way that it can accept only a particular grade of raw material. So that is where our long-term revenue model is.
And going forward, we'll also look at some revenue sharing once the brand becomes big and we have more incoming franchisee demand.
What about you, Mr. Chakravarti? You are like in sanitation?
So we are not in sanitation. In healthcare, we are in the diagnostic kits, those kind of
things.
So also, a lot of your portfolio companies would be there who are into local distribution. I'd just like to add that with iSolar Light, they have like a good distribution in UP. So we also did a pilot with them in terms of distribution. So beyond investment, beyond real funding, there is also a lot of support that all the social enterprises can give to each other. So wherever we are, we can probably
partner. Are you in touch with Institute?
Yes, so I know Aditi and we use their Marathi curriculum for awareness generation.
Brilliant.
Swanacharya,
would you be interested in coming on this?
How much is your, does your vending machine cost?
It's a 25,000 rupee machine, but with bigger order quantities, there is discount in there as well.
Where are these installed?
So we have installed it in 12 schools. All of them are municipal schools in Mumbai and Greater Mumbai.
Great.
Thank you.